What's up? You ever wondered what it'd be like to run your very own mainframe? Well, today in this video, I'm going to show you how to install the Hercules Emulator that runs the MVS 3.8, which is an IBM mainframe software that runs directly on your Windows PC. And that's right, it is fully legal and it's absolutely free. So stick around to the end of this video because I will be showing you how to run your very first JCL job. So come with me and follow along and start your mainframe journey today. And before we get started, I'd just like to let you know that all the downloadable links are in the description below. Timestamps are also listed below, so skip through the steps that you need to. Let's get started. All right, so the first step is we're going to go and download the MVS TK5. So we're going to scroll down, click on the first link to download. And it's always a good idea to download the PDF. It's always a good read. Next, we're going to go and download the WC3270, which is just click on this link right here and start the download. Next, we're going to go extract the MVS TK5 and move it to CMVS MVS TK5. Just put it directly in the root, hit extract. Good. Now the next step is that we have to run this unattended. So you go in this MVS TK5, click on unattended folder, and just double click on set console mode.bat. Once it runs, just hit any key to continue. You're good to go. Next, we got to go back to the MVS TK5 folder. And we're going to double click on MVS.bat to execute the Hercules emulator. So double click on that guy. If you see this window, just hit more info, run anyways. And there you have it. Hercules is running. Just hit allow. Good. Let it do its thing. Once you see the cat and you see the TK5 logo, you're ready to go. Next, we're going to install the WC3270. Just double click on the setup. Just hit yes. Just do all the defaults, so hit next, 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 install. Good, just launch. Okay, so now on these setups, we're gonna create a new session. So type one. And hit enter. Session name, call it whatever you like. I called it MVS. Hit enter. Host IP address 127.0.0.1. Everyone knows that one. Hit enter. Next, we need to change this TCP port, which is, I believe, is option 3. So, right at the bottom, type 3 and hit enter. Port is 3270, and hit enter. Good. Okay, then all you just say yes. And I just say yeah. This is a weird question at this point to say yes and just erase that. And good. There you go. You have it. Said 9 to quit. Now you have a desktop. Icon is on this on the desktop now. Double click on that. And now you have the MVS TK5. Great. So now you have both windows running. So you have to keep both the WC3270 running and the Hercules emulator running at the same time. Now that we got the installation out of the way, now it's time to set up your first job. Good. Now to log on to MVS, hit the enter key. And for the user ID, we just type Herc01, which is the basic admin. And the password is see you later. Type to see you later, hit enter. Now, when you see these broadcasting messages, every time you see asterisks, just hit enter. Hit enter, because it's waiting for you to answer. And now you are in the ISPF primary menu. So next we're gonna do, we're gonna run your job. So right at the option command line, just make sure you hit the home key on your keyboard. It'll always take you to the top of the command line. Type in equal 3.4. Hit enter. Now on the dataset name prefix, we're gonna type sys2.jcllib. I'm gonna go into that dataset, tab over, press B for browse. Now at the top of the command line, we're gonna use this command, which is L space, and we're gonna do test, which means we're gonna locate a member named test. And then it takes us down, we'll just tab over to the member called test cob. And in this example, I'm gonna be doing a view. View allows me to edit, but not commit any changes. Then on line 4, we're gonna tab over on line 4 where it says message class A, we're gonna change it to an X. And then we're gonna scroll down to the bottom. And we're gonna go to line 32 on the Sysout. We're gonna put an asterisk. So we're gonna change from A to an asterisk. And then to run your job, home on the command line and type the command sub for sub to submit. Hit enter. And there's your job name, test cob. And with the job ID, it's been submitted. Hit enter. Now to get out of the JCL lib, I have to hit cancel because I went in view. So type cancel, hit enter. Now to go see the Sysout, to go see how what my results were, I hit home, always to the command line, and the shortcut is equal 3.8. 3.8, hit enter. Takes me directly to the spool, to GA. Now I tab down, where you see the member right there, which is test cob, which was my job. Tab all the way down. I type select S on that to select this member. Hit enter. Now all I can tell you is that this is where you see where the return codes are. There's 0, meaning the job ran fine. Now press F8 on your keyboard to scroll down. As you press F8, you can scroll down more. We're gonna scroll down and take a look. Right about in the middle of the screen, you can see the word hello world. This is what this job does. It executes and compiles this program to type the hello world. There's your job. There's your program layout and what was used. And that's it. You've just successfully ran your very first JCL job on the mainframe. Now to shut down, We're going to do equal X from here. And on the TSO command line where it says ready, if you did this by accident and you want to go back to your ISPF mainframe, just type ISPF. But let's do our shutdown now. So we'll do equal X. And on the command below the ready, we type the word shutdown. Hit enter. So this is just to show you that behind the scenes, the Hercules Emulator has already begun its shutdown procedure. So now I tap, make sure I'm on the ready. I type log off. Now I'm logging off ISPF. I'm logged off ISPF. And I close the window. Let Hercules run its thing. And it shuts off on its own. And there you have it. Well, I hope you found this tutorial helpful. This is just the first stepping stone towards mastering the mainframe. Now would be a good time to ask you to smash the like and subscribe button if you really like this content, as I will be posting more mainframe related tutorials on MVS 3.8. So stay tuned for more upcoming videos as I will be diving deeper into JCL, ISPF, and absolutely COBOL. I would like to thank you for watching, and I will see you later.